established the moon and the sun. You fixed all the boundaries of the earth. You made both summer and winter.
O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Psalms 128, 129, and 130.
Happy are all who fear the Lord and who follow in his ways. You shall eat the fruit of your labor. Happiness and prosperity shall be yours. Your eyes shall be like a fruitful vine within your house. Your children like olive shoots run about your table. The man who fears the Lord shall thus indeed be blessed. The Lord bless you from Zion. And may you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life. May you live to see your children's children. May peace be upon Israel.
Greatly have they oppressed me since my youth. Let Israel now say,
greatly have they oppressed me since my youth. But they have not prevailed against me. The plowmen plowed upon my back and made the furrows long. The Lord, the righteous one, has cut the cord of the wicked. Let them be put to shame and thrown back. All those who are enemies of Zion, let them be like grass upon the housetops, which withers before it can be plucked, which does not feel the hand of the reaper, nor the bosom of him who binds the sheaves, so that those who go by say not much as, the Lord prosper you. We wish you well in the name of the Lord. At all the debts have I called to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears consider well the voice of my supplication. If you, Lord, were to note what is done amiss, O Lord, who could stand? For there is forgiveness with you. Therefore you shall be filled. I wait for the Lord, my soul waits for him.
word of the Lord concerning Israel. Thus says the Lord, who stretched out the heavens and founded the earth, and formed the human spirit within. See, I am about to make Jerusalem a cup of reeling for all the surrounding peoples. It will be against Judah also in the siege against Jerusalem. On that day I will make Jerusalem a heavy stone for all the peoples. All who lift it shall grievously hurt themselves. And all the nations of the earth shall come together against it. On that day, says the Lord, I will strike every horse with panic, and its rider with madness. But on the house of Judah I will keep a watchful eye. When I strike every horse of the peoples with blindness, then the clans of Judah shall say to themselves, the inhabitants of Jerusalem have strength through the Lord of hosts, their God. On that day I will make the clans of Judah like a blazing pot on a pile of wood, like a flaming torch among sheaves, and they shall devour to the right and to the left all the surrounding peoples, while Jerusalem shall again be inhabited in its place, in Jerusalem. And the Lord will give victory to the tents of Judah first, that the glory of the house of David and the glory of the inhabitants of Jerusalem may not be exalted over that of Judah. On that day the Lord will shield the inhabitants of Jerusalem, so that the feeblest among them on that day shall be like David, and the house of David shall be like God, like the angel of the Lord at their head. And on that day I will seek to destroy all the nations that come against Jerusalem, and I will pour out a spirit of compassion and supplication on the house of David. And the inhabitants of Jerusalem, so that when they look on the one whom they have pierced, they shall mourn for him, as one mourns for an only child, and weep bitterly over him, as one weeps over a firstborn. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Respect it,
Gospel of Matthew, the 19th chapter, beginning with the 23rd verse. Jesus said to his disciples, "Truly I tell you, it will be hard for a rich person to enter the kingdom of heaven. Again I tell you, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God." When the disciples heard this, they were greatly astounded and said, "Who then can be saved?" But Jesus looked at them and said, "For mortals it is impossible, but for God all things are possible." Then Peter said in reply, "Look, we have left everything and followed you. What then will we have?" Jesus said to them, "Truly I tell you, at the renewal of all things, when the Son of Man is seated on the throne of his glory, you who have followed me will also sit on 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And everyone who has left houses or brothers or sisters, father or mother or children or fields for my sake, will receive 100-fold and will inherit eternal life. But many who are first will be last, and the last will be first." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you now have set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Saviour, whom you have prepared for all the world to see. A light to enlighten the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you,
and also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Let your people sing with joy. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world, for only in you can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under your care, and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let your way be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us with your Holy Spirit. Almighty and everlasting God, whose will it is to restore all things in your well-beloved Son, the King of kings and Lord of lords, mercifully grant that the peoples of the earth, divided and enslaved by sin, may be freed and brought together under his most gracious rule, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Most holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments, and all just words, give to us, your servants, that peace which the world so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of all enemies, may live in peace and quietness, through the mercies of Christ Jesus our Saviour. Amen. Be our light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this life, for the love of your only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
O God, the life of all who live, the light of the faithful, the strength of those who labour, and the repose of the dead, we thank you for the blessings of the day that is past, and humbly ask for your protection through this coming night. Bring us in safety to the morning rose, through him who died and rose again for us, even your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Let us bless them.
Thanks be to God.
Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the Church, and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever.
Amen.
From Monday of next week, when we'll be in the season of Advent, both Morning Prayer and Evensong will be live streamed from here in St. John's. Morning Prayer at 8 a.m. and Evening Prayer from at 4:30 p.m. The best way to access those live streams is actually through the parish website in the page entitled Service This Week, and they will link through to the stream of the office either at the time it is live or at any time thereafter.